Good morning student. In this lecture we are studied about the reference circle method. For that purpose we have to draw the three figure of the projection of rotating rod. Figure, in this figure it can show that rod is rotating in a vertical circle along y axis in xy plane. Let us consider the rod is rotating in xy plane. If this rod is illuminated parallel to the rod on either sides of linear source and parallel to the x axis, then its shadow or projection is produced on y axis, and the tip of projection is oscillating about the origin O along the y-axis. Let us consider this rod is rotating in xy plane. If this rod is illuminated parallel to the rod by the linear source, then its shadow or projection it is produced on y-axis. And this tip of shadow is oscillating about the origin O, is as shown in figure A. We shall now prove that if the tip of projection is performing simple harmonic motion, if corresponding motion of tip of rod is performing uniform circular motion, then for that purpose we have to take the projection of displacement velocity on the reference diameter. Therefore I am getting all this quantity for the linear simple harmonic motion. Therefore for that purpose we have to draw the figure. Let us consider an anti-clockwise uniform circular motion particle P. Let us consider an anti-clockwise uniform circular motion of particle P, and its position decided with reference OX. If this particle is at E position, then its angular position is 0. If this particle is at E position, then its angular position is 0. If this particle is at F, then its angular position is pi by 2 or 90. Or if particle is at G position, then there is its angular position is 180 degree. If it is particle at the position E, then it is again 360 degree. Let us consider R is equal to OP is the position vector of the particle P. At t is equal to 0, when time period interval is t is equal to 0, then let us consider the particle B at the position P0 with reference angle phi. Let us consider at the time interval t is equal to 0, then particle B, it is at the reference angle phi. It moves with an angular, during time t, it moves with an angular displacement, that is omega t. Therefore, when this particle moves during time t, then its phase angle theta is equal to, it moves with an reference angle, then phase angle theta is equal to, it is equal to omega t plus phi. It moves with an reference angle omega t plus phi. phase angle. Then R is the position vector of that particle. Therefore, we have to label OM. OM it is equal to R is equal to OP is the position of the particle. Therefore, label OM on the y-axis here and take consider FH is the reference diameter. Reference diameter along y-axis and label this OM. R is equal to OP on y-axis. Therefore, projection of the displacement during time t. During time t, the projection or position vector is given by OM. OM is equal to OP sin theta. OM is equal to OP sin theta. OP sin theta. Here we can get OM is equal to OP sin theta. Where OM it is represented by Y and OP it is represented by R. Therefore, we can write here OM is equal to OM it is represented by Y and therefore we can write here Y is equal to OM it is denoted by Y and OP is represented by R. Therefore, OM is equal to Y R sin theta. But theta is equal to omega t plus phi. Therefore, we get Y is equal to R sin omega t plus phi. This is the equation of linear simple harmonic motion of an amplitude R. Here R represent amplitude and Y represent the position vector of that particle along Y axis. This is the equation of simple harmonic motion of amplitude R. In this case, omega represents angular velocity in circular motion. But in case of linear simple harmonic motion, here omega represents the angular frequency. After that, we can study about the projection of velocity, how it can be projected. Therefore, for that purpose, instantaneous velocity of the particle, it means the velocity of particle changes at the time t is equal to 0. Therefore, instantaneous velocity of the particle is the tangential velocity of magnitude r omega, which is directed along O towards the O. Therefore, instantaneous velocity of the particle p, instantaneous velocity of the particle p in circular motion, it is given by along y-axis. Then its projection on reference diameter, along y-axis is given by Vy is equal to R omega cos omega t plus phi. This is the projection of an velocity. Here we get the velocity for linear simple harmonic motion. Again we get this velocity for linear simple harmonic motion for corresponding uniform circular motion. Then after that, projection of an acceleration. Instantaneous acceleration of the particle in circular motion is the radial or centripetal acceleration, which is directed towards the center O. Instantaneous acceleration of the particle P in circular motion, it is the radial or centripetal pressure which is directed towards the O. Therefore, its projection on reference navigator, it is given by its projection on reference diameter is given by, here along y axis we can write ay is equal to minus r omega square sine theta. We can get the acceleration which is directed towards the center O. Therefore, we get the acceleration, centripetal acceleration sine theta, but theta is equal to omega t plus phi. Therefore, acceleration Ay along y-axis, we get minus r omega square sine omega t plus phi. This is the radial, we get acceleration here, or also linear simple harmonic motion. From this analogy, it is clear that from this we can see that displacement, we can get here displacement, also velocity and acceleration for the linear simple harmonic motion. From this analogy, we can say that the projection of any quantity for circular motion, projection of any quantity for circular motion, it gives the corresponding quantity for linear simple harmonic motion. We can see that all these quantity getting for this linear simple harmonic motion. When we project any quantity for circular motion, it get the quantities for linear simple harmonic motion. We can say that this is the projection of UCM along any diameter. After that, we can discuss about the phase in simple harmonic motion. Phase is the state of oscillation of the particle. It is called as phase. State of oscillation represent the phase in simple harmonic motion. State of oscillation is the phase in simple harmonic motion. To know about the phase in simple harmonic motion, it is necessary to know about the displacement as well as velocity, oscillation number, how many oscillation takes place at that time. To know about the state, we have to know at first displacement, velocity and oscillation number. Knowing displacement is not enough for the state of oscillation, because there are two positions of velocity, and knowing the velocity is not enough for state, because there are two positions of the particle. Therefore, we have to consider the quantity which changes with time. They are in this condition repeats for successive oscillation. Therefore, we have to consider the quantity changes with respect to time. For that purpose, we have to consider the projection. It is clear from that